Okay, so here we have to solve this rational inequality. 4x plus 4 divided by x plus 3 is less than or equal to 3. Now, at first, you might think, well, we can just multiply both sides by x plus 3, get rid of that denominator, and now all we'll have is a linear inequality, which we can solve just moving some terms around. Except, that kind of messes things up because we don't know if x plus 3 is a positive number or a negative number, right? If x is very low, or if x is, say, negative 5, this will be a negative number. And when we multiply both sides of an inequality by a negative number, we have to flip the inequality sign. But if it's positive, we won't have to flip the inequality sign. And so it kind of messes things up because we don't know whether to flip or not, and we have to consider all these weird cases. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to subtract 3 from both sides. In other words, move all the terms to one side. And then we can find a common denominator. Combine these two fractions together. So I'm going to multiply this 3 by x plus 3 divided by x plus 3. So multiply and divide by the same thing. And then now, when they have the same denominator, we can combine their numerators. So I have negative 3 times x, that's negative 3x. And negative 3 times 3, that's negative 9. So if we combine like terms in the numerator, right, 4x minus 3x is x. 4 minus 9 is negative 5. We get x minus 5 over x plus 3 is less than or equal to 0. And what we can do here, I won't go into too much of the detail, but basically the only way this can change from negative to positive is when either the numerator is 0 or the denominator is 0. And so if we solve for x in both those cases, we can find possible points where it changes from negative to positive, right? We're trying to find whether when it's negative or 0. So we're trying to find where are those regions where it could be negative. And so if we just solve, pretty simple, x equals 5 and x equals negative 3. And so what we're going to do is we're going to plot those what we call critical points on a number line, negative 3 and 5, and then we're going to use some test values to see whether in each of these three regions is our expression here positive or negative, right? We're trying to find whether it's neither negative or 0. So if we test a point, say negative 10, way to the left of negative 3, well, we're going to get a negative number, right, negative 15, and we're going to get another negative number in the denominator, so negative divided by negative is positive. And so we're positive in this region. Keep in mind, at negative 3, this expression is not defined. So I don't know if you've seen this notation, but we have open circle to say it's not defined at that point. In between negative 3 and 5, let's say I test 0, that's the easy point. We'll get negative 5 divided by positive 3, that's a negative number. And so in this entire region, we're negative. And to the right of 5, right, that's our other critical point. Say just test a large positive number, let's say like 20. Well, we're going to get positive number in the numerator, positive number in the denominator, so we get a positive number. And so our final answer, right, we're trying to find where is this inequality, right, back to our original inequality, less than or equal to 0 in this case. Well, that's from negative 3 to 5, but not including negative 3, because it's not equal to 0 there, it's undefined there. But at 5, right, if we plug in 5 into this expression, it is equal to 0, and so we include 5. And so we can either write it like this, negative 3, x is greater than negative 3 and less than or equal to positive 5, or in interval notation from negative 3 to 5, 5 with that closed bracket, that means we're including it, and negative 3 that open bracket, which means we don't include it.